Have you thought about installing an updesk in your RV to make it a lot easier to work on the computer? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how I built this IKEA updesk with custom tabletop and with adjustable monitor arms so that it would make it a lot more comfortable and easier for me to work long hours on the computer. So this desk is an IKEA updesk frame attached to a piece of wood that I got at Lowe's and had cut at Lowe's. The frame itself comes from IKEA and is about $450, and I got this piece of wood at Lowe's for about $35. I have dual monitor arms attached, which I got on Amazon, I think, for about $50. Now, one of the important things about having a computer desk in the RV was that on moving day, I knew that I would be able to move without the desk or the computer getting jostled around while we travel. So this desk is bolted to the floor. I'll show some video about how I drilled the frame and bolted it right to the floor. And when it's down in its lowest position, it is really solid and it's not moving anywhere. The dual monitor arms are awesome because when it's a moving day, all I have to do is move the monitors forward and then down. They go right on top of the desk like this. And I have a strap that goes across that holds them in place. And I'll show you some pictures of how I did that when I moved the first time. I'm probably gonna build some little rubber bumpers for these corners on my 3D printer. I can print in like a rubber material, so help take a little bit of cushion on these monitors while they're traveling down the road. But on my first trip, moving them with the strap, it worked great. I got to my location, they hadn't moved anywhere. Now this desk's highest position is 50 inches and its lowest position is 24. Now, the awesome thing about having an up desk is that you can change your working position. That's obviously, I'm not that tall, so I wouldn't have it this high, but it goes to 50 inches for somebody who's tall. This way, I could work at the computer at a comfortable height. I can move the monitors exactly the height that I want and have my head in a very ergonomic position. When I'm ready to sit again, I can just hold the button down and bring my chair out here. I just use a folding chair. I bring that down into this position. I get it at the height that I want. If I'm gonna be typing for long periods of time, I get it down nice and low so that my keyboard is in a very comfortable position for typing and that my head is in a good position. If I wanna move it up again, I just move it up and get it in position. If I want it closer, I can move it closer. If I want it further away, I can move it further away. I can get it exactly the way I want. I have a second monitor, mostly for when I work in Premiere. I have my folders organized over here, so that way I can keep my timeline, my program monitor, my source monitor open all the time, and I don't have to worry about moving things back and forth. It's a very clean setup. Almost everything up here on the desk that's powered is powered by a power adapter that I have screwed to the bottom of the table so those cables don't go down to the floor. I only have one power cable that attaches up here to the bottom of the desk. And then I have a power adapter over here if I've got anything else that I wanna power, like this is my laptop powered here. I just power it up here on a power adapter that I have attached to the top of the desk. It makes a very clean setup. It's so clean that I'm gonna probably put in some plastic storage cabinets in the back here where I can keep maybe some camera equipment. We're eventually gonna be putting a small little cabinet or desk here so that when we're sitting on this couch, we have a place to put our drinks. It makes for a very open setup, a very clean setup. Now, I have built this computer case a couple years ago and it just worked out perfectly that it's kind of between the frame here and the wall so that when we're traveling, the computer is not gonna move around a lot. I'm probably eventually gonna put some foam bumpers between the wall and between the frame so that I don't have to worry about the components in the computer, you know, rattling loose. We can easily move the computer and the mouse out of the way. We can get the laptop out of the way here. And then if we want to, Alice and I can sit and eat at this table. Now, generally we either eat outside or we eat on the couch, but I haven't had this installed very long, but on a night where we can't go outside, but we want to sit and eat at a table, there's plenty of room for two people to eat at this desk. it's at a nice height. If I'd rather work on my laptop instead, I can just keep my laptop here. I can adjust the height exactly the way I want to work on my laptop. Open up my laptop, or the desk is still big enough that I can have my laptop open over here and have my desktop computer up here and still have lots of room. A lot of times I work with notes and I can have my notes right here. So there's lots of room to work at this desk, whether you're in the sitting position or in the standing position, you've got lots of room. It's a very clean install. I got my speakers back in the corner. I'm probably gonna get some more compact speakers. I've got my backup drive up here. I've got my Wi-Fi adapter up here, my microphone and my headphones, and that's pretty much all I keep on my desk.
Okay, I'm gonna walk you through the building procedure for the desk from IKEA. It comes in two boxes. One is mostly the frame, and then the other box are the motorized legs. This whole kit actually goes together really quickly. I was actually kind of surprised. I'm putting together the base frame right there, and that is dependent upon how long of a table you decide to use. They sell it at IKEA. They sell a 47 inch and a 63 inch, and you can adjust the size of the base frame that goes across the middle of the desk based upon how wide you want the desk to be. I made mine at 53 inches, but I probably could have gone, I think, as low as 48 inches or less if I wanted to. Or I could go as big as probably, you know, 63 inches as the desk that comes from IKEA. Now, you can also buy the tabletop that comes from IKEA. It's really good, but it was just too heavy and too thick and too expensive. The tabletop itself was about 150 bucks. But I just continued to follow the instructions and put the pieces together. It was just a bunch of bolts and screws. I think it all took me maybe about half an hour to build the desk. It's basically the powered legs attached to the metal frame, and then at the end you attach the legs just with a couple screws from the bottom, and those power onto the legs. I decided not to put those feet on because I was going to screw the desk directly to the floor, so those little feet that are usually used to adjust the height I left off. Here I am attaching the electronics. It takes just a couple minutes. There's a couple of plugs between the controller and the desk, and then from the controller to the motors. This is where I lay down the desk tabletop that I got from Lowe's. I just laid it down the floor, measured out approximately where I wanted to put it, and I attached it with 8 screws. Each corner has a spot for 2 screw holes to attach the desk. And you know, that went down really easily. I just had to make sure that I used screws that were short enough that they wouldn't go all the way through, but I wanted to use fat enough screws that would be really securely attached to the desk. Here I am just testing it out, going up and down a couple of times, and was just loving how awesome it was moving. Now it was time to get rid of this old computer desk. I ended up taking this to Goodwill the next day, and they were glad to have it. It was actually still in really good condition. Alice's helping me move the desk in here. It actually wasn't that heavy. We just had to make sure we get it exactly where we wanted to. Here I am drilling some holes and into the steel frame, and then putting some good-sized screws into the floor. After I put these in there, this thing was bolted down so tight it wasn't going anywhere after that. Here I am just assembling the arms for the monitor. It's a pretty easy kit you get from Amazon. It comes out of the box pretty much ready to go. You just attach the arms to each monitor, and then to slide the clamp to the desk, and then each arm just slides over the clamp. You just pop those into place. At this time, I just had the one monitor, so I'm only going to show putting the one monitor on the arm right here, but they both go on the same, and it's a really easy process. There's some adjustment you have to do depending on how heavy the monitor is. You have to create more tension in the arm so that it will hold it up straight.
Please leave me a comment. Let me know what you think of my up desk in the RV. Check out this playlist over here where I go through the 10 days countdown to Alice and I going full time. Please subscribe, and remember, downsizing does make sense.